Hey YouTube, it's Tristan from Smart Home Point here. I want to speak to you today about how you can play music on your Google Mini or Google Nest Mini device if you're not willing to pay for Spotify Premium. And this is because a lot of the free music options contain a lot of adverts. But obviously when you want to listen to music, you don't really want to be bombarded with ads. Now, as it happens, there are four really awesome methods you can use to play free music on your Google Home device with no ads whatsoever. And I want to cover these in this video. Okay, so the first option is to play MP3s on your Google Mini or Google Nest Mini device. Now you might be wondering how you do this because obviously you can't store MP3 files directly on here. But what you can do is sign up for a free Google Play Music account. And as part of that, you can upload up to 50,000 MP3 files to your music library. You can then organize these MP3s into playlists and you can play those playlists for free with no adverts on your Google Nest Mini device. Let's have a look at how you do this. Okay, so the first thing you want to do is go to Google Play Music. Searched it earlier, Google Play Music. And you'll be presented with their subscription plans, but the key thing to do here is just click No Thanks, making sure you're logged into the cracked Google account that you want to use. So we click No Thanks, and it says, obviously with our free service, you can upload your iTunes, Windows Media, or any other collections, which is really key here for this particular tip. So it says here that they need to take some payment details, but you won't be charged for the standard service. So I'll just mute this video and go ahead and add these payment card details. Okay, that's done. I've added that and it says payment successful, but I haven't made any payments. I've literally just linked it to my payment method. Obviously, I've clicked the free plan, so I won't be charged anything. That will now load. It will load my music library, which is obviously empty. So we'll come here, top left. Still empty there. So on the top left, we'll click the little menu bar there. We will go to upload music. And you can, as it says, drag and drop songs here, or you can select them from your computer. Now, I've got probably around 1,500 MP3s, but they will, copyrighted music. So what I'm going to do is pick a free song which has, the relevant access rights so that this video won't get banned by YouTube, basically. So what do I do? Let's download. Thanks for that. All right, let's download that music. MP3 file. Okay, and then I will drag and drop that up to the Google Play library. Click continue. And I need to add to Chrome, fair enough. Yes, fine. Right, what is it doing? Okay, so I think now it's actually added it as an app. Okay, that's a bit confusing. Let's restart and let's see the original web page and let's try that again. Right. So upload music, upload that again. This time it's done something. Yes, so this time it's actually uploading. Okay, so after waiting around a minute, which is a little bit slow, but after waiting a minute, you've got this tick and it says one song added, which is great. And if you wanted, you can play it here, which I'll quickly do. Yep, great, that's there. Now, I previously mentioned that you, as part of this tip, for playing free music on your Google Nest Mini, you have to organize things into playlists. It's just a little quirk of this particular tip. So the way we will do that is go to the song screen, click on the three dots, click add to playlist and new playlist. Now for the purposes of this test, I'm gonna literally call the playlist Skies and Shadows. And this is so that I can say to Google play, Skies and Shadows. Obviously you can name the playlist what you want. You can name it by an album or anything else you wanted. Okay, so we can create playlist. Now this is all set up. The next thing we need to do is make sure that Google Music is set up as the supplier of music in our Google Home app. So we'll go and do that now.
Okay, so on the Google Home app, we will go to settings, we will go to music. And once it loads, at the moment, I'm linked to a Spotify free account, which obviously has loads of ads, but We will instead go to Google Play Music, and it says it's the default music provider, and that will allow us to play the MP3s, or in this case, the MP3 that we have just uploaded. So let's give that a try now. Hey, play Skies and Shadows.
All right, playing the song Skies and Shadows from your Google Play Music library.
Okay, the second method is to play music or audio on your mobile phone and then use the Google Home app to cast audio onto your Google Mini device. As long as you have access to ad-free music on your mobile phone, this is a really great method. Let's have a look at how we do this. Okay, so using this method, you'll want to start playing music on your mobile phone. This could be through a podcast site or YouTube or SoundCloud, especially if you have an app that blocks ads. But in this case, I'm going to carry on using Skies and Shadows from the Free Music Archive. So what I'll start doing is playing that song. Okay, and now I will go to my Google Home app. I'll go into it. So it says pass to my device. Okay, so the third method is to use your Google Mini device as a Bluetooth speaker. It's very simple, very straightforward, and nearly every laptop, tablet, and mobile phone supports Bluetooth nowadays. So you simply start playing music on one of your devices, you turn on Bluetooth, and then you stream it to your Google Mini device. There are two ways that you can turn your Google Mini device into a Bluetooth speaker. Let's have a look at how you do that now. Okay, so to get started with using your Google Mini as a Bluetooth speaker, we'll firstly go to the Google Home app, make sure that's on. We'll then select your Google Mini device. In the top right, you click the three buttons. No, you don't, sorry. You click the cog and you go to settings. That connects to your device. Then what we'll do is go down to paired Bluetooth devices. So you see here it says that no Bluetooth devices have been set up. So we'll say enable pairing mode. Great. So now what we'll do is go over to our laptop and continue the process over there. Okay, so now I want to go to the device which I'll be casting music from, in this case, this computer that I'm on. So I will do, I'll just close that. What I'll do is click on the Windows key, search for Bluetooth, click this result. And I want to make sure that Bluetooth is turned on. I'll then want to click on Add Bluetooth to other device, click Bluetooth. And the living room speaker is the name of my Google Mini device, so I'll select that. Okay, it says it's ready to go. Device ready to pair. Sometimes it says this, click OK. What you might then need to do is actually wait a few more seconds and it'll say paired and then click on connect. I don't know why it sometimes does that, it just glitches a little bit. Okay, I'm now finally connected. As I said, sometimes it can glitch up a little bit. The next thing to do is just go to the device you want to play music from, and once you click play, it'll just play automatically to your Google Mini device. Okay, the fourth method available to you is to use the Google Chrome web browser on a computer. Start playing music on there, then click the cast button and cast music to your Google Mini device. As long as your computer and the Mini are on the same home network, this works perfectly well. It's really easy to do. And the benefit of this approach is that on a computer, you'll have access to literally thousands of different free music sources, which don't have any adverts whatsoever. So by clicking cast, you're then obviously casting completely free music to Google Mini, which also doesn't have any adverts. Let's have a look how we do this. Okay, so for the fourth method, you can use the cast feature on the Google Chrome browser, which you can see by clicking settings. There's a cast button. Now this is really useful because you can actually go to any website and as long as it plays music or audio, you can cast that to Google Mini device. In this case, I'm going to use YouTube. I've got an ad blocker on there, simple Chrome plugin, and that means that I'm never actually going to see any adverts. So I'll start playing a song, and then what I'll do is click on cast and you'll see it appear in my Google Mini playing there instead. So let's start that now. Okay, so I go to the top right, I click on cast, and I can select a device. In this case, my living room speaker is my Google Mini device. Okay, and when you want to finish that, at the top right, it says it's displaying on another screen. Click that, and it'll stop playing on your Google Mini device. I hope you enjoyed that video. This is the first video on the Smart Home Point YouTube channel, but we'll be producing a lot more. So if you like this video, please subscribe. Don't forget to hit the like button. Thank you.